In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, today the church throughout the world celebrates the solemnity of the Annunciation. The angel Gabriel called Mary of Nazareth, who was full of grace, to bear the Savior and Redeemer of the whole world. Mary's yes set into motion the dawning of a new and eternal age. God's call and Mary's response is the pattern of life for each of us, as we are also invited to bear Christ to the world through our work, prayer, and common life together. Invoking the prayers of Our Lady during this difficult time for our community and our world, let us acknowledge our sins and failings and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and man may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask for a sign from the Lord, your God. Let it be deep as the nether world or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David. Is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sacrifice and offerings, but in an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Then I said, "See, I have come." The scroll of the book, it stands written of me, "I delight to do your will, O my God." Your instruction lies deep within me. Yeah. justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord. Here am I, Lord. I come to do your will. Your saving help I have not hidden in my heart. Of your faithfulness and salvation I have spoken. I made no secrets of your merciful love and your faithfulness to the great assembly.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight." Then I said, as is written of me in the scroll, "Behold, I come to do your will, O God." First, he says, "Sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law." Then he says, "Behold, I come to do your will." He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, once and for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. To understand and to look into this feast day, a good word for us is a word in Spanish. Carne. Do we all know what carne? I'll ask these seventh graders, eighth graders, ninth graders, seventh? Okay, seventh graders. We'll ask you because you're close. All right, carne. How many people know what that word means? Anybody know? Yes. Who wants to say right there in the middle? Meat. Perfect. All right. She gets an A for today. All right. Now, we're going to get back. So think of that idea. We're going to get to what we call the incarnation. Carne. Incarnation in just a minute. So Mary is in Nazareth. We think she was a young woman, probably around 15 years old. And in her culture at that time, that was the age at which young people got married. Of course, in our culture now, it's 19, 20, 21, 25, 30, and that. But in her culture, 15 years old would be a time to get married. And so she was betrothed to Joseph, all set up. Wedding date is in the future. And now, there she is, and the angel Gabriel appears to her. Of course, it says that one of the things he says to her is, "Do not be afraid." And of course, you know, if an angel appeared to you, angel appeared to me, the first thing I think of is, oh no, you know, it's kind of like so unusual. Do not be afraid. Now, do not be afraid. What drives out fear? What drives out fear? Love. Love drives out fear. The angel says to her, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. God is with you. She comes to understand that God is coming to her and reaching out to her, what we would come to understand in a unique and special way, that is just, this is the only time in human history ever that God would touch humanity in this way. And so Mary then listens to what God says to her through the angel Gabriel. You will conceive in your womb and bear a son and call him Jesus. Jesus means, Yeshua means God saves. He will be great and called Son of the Most High. He will be the Messiah. For 2,000 years, the people of Israel have waited for a Messiah. And now, the Son of God, the Messiah, will come among you. You'll have the throne of his father David, just as we heard in that first reading. And so it's that the Holy Spirit comes upon her. What do we mean that the Holy Spirit comes upon her, that overshadows her? It means that God in the Holy Spirit comes upon her, and then in her womb is incarnated, made into human flesh, God. God takes on a human flesh. That God, who is God, what we call then the second person of the Trinity, takes on and becomes one of us, takes on the human. Each of us are incarnated, if you will. Each of us is human flesh. Each of us is a human person. And so God, as the Holy Spirit, overshadows Mary. And in her womb then is that comes, will be that little tiny baby that will grow and grow in the womb until 9 months from now, then be born Jesus, come into the world, be born as we know in Bethlehem. And so the angel then goes on and explains to her, your cousin, your kinswoman, Elizabeth, who's elderly, unable to have children, she's too old to have children, too elderly, is indeed with child. And so there's a miracle sign, a sign that's given to Mary. We know, of course, in the story, immediately after this, Mary heads off to the hill country to be with Elizabeth. And then, the very end, behold, I'm the handmaid of the Lord. Behold, I'm the servant. I am one of God's people. And be it done to me according to God's word. And then the angel departed from her. May it be done to me according to God's word. Mary says, yes. Now, Mary did not understand what was going to go on at all. I mean, she had some idea of God and Messiah and that. But when she said yes, it was stepping out in an area that was completely unknown to her, that she completely put her trust in God. Completely put her trust in God. And she knew deep in her heart that God would be with her throughout the rest of her life. And again, she would have no idea of the future that God had in store for her. What we all know so well in the story of Mary and going through, and of course then the appearances of the Blessed Mother and all of that, and and her intercessory prayer for us, her role in salvation history, all of this would be completely unknown to her. And so we don't just celebrate the event of the Annunciation at 2,000 years ago when Mary said yes, but it's meant to teach us something. It's meant to teach us, what are we to say as God approaches us? Now, I don't expect that an angel is going to appear, but God calls each person. God moves in the life of each person. And let me suggest one thing for you. Let me suggest one thing for you today. So when you stand up towards the end of Mass, and those of you that go to communion, form that line, okay? Form that line, and it's an altar call, if you will. If we take evangelical language, it's an altar call. Those of you that believe in Jesus, we ask you to stand up. And then the priest, the deacon, the minister will say to you, body of Christ, of course we also say blood of Christ, body of Christ, and you say amen. You say amen. And what does that amen mean? Let me suggest today that that amen means that you are saying, may it be done to me according to your word, God's word, according to God's working in my life. Let me do that. Let me take up what God is calling me to do. That God's movement in my life. Now, each person is going to be just a little bit different. We're all very, very different people. But what we celebrate today is not just the beauty of the Annunciation and God coming to be human. The entire history of the world is changed because of the Incarnation. That God comes into eternity, breaks into human history, and the world is forever changed. And so in our own small way, because, you know, that's who we are, in our own small way, God works through each and every one of you. God moves in you, and you are then invited to say, yes. Yes. Let it be done to me, God, as you say. Today, then, we're going to make our profession of faith. And because it is the special day of the Incarnation, the special day of the Annunciation, we get to the words, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, what we celebrate today. What we're going to do is genuflect, just down on one knee and back up, just an acknowledgement of the incarnation. So get to that point, and I'll say, and by, down, and up. Together then. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, today we recall the humble woman of Nazareth, who heard in the words of Gabriel the first news of our salvation. Joining with Our Lady and the saints, let us offer our prayers and petitions for the needs of the whole world.
For the Church, for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Oscar, and all the faithful, that like Mary Immaculate, full of grace, we may respond to God's call with willing hearts, serving as priests, prophets, and kings.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
For the human family, especially in Myanmar, Syria, Venezuela, Yemen, that God will rid our troubled lands of hatred, war, racism, bloodshed, and grant us the courage and grace to promote justice in every corner of the earth.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, especially all who are battling the coronavirus, for the hungry, the unemployed, and those without safe shelter, for all who are detained, all who are crushed by poverty, and for those whose life is fragile and vulnerable, that through Our Lady's intercession, Christians may see her Son in all those who are in need.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died, especially Diane Pardes, Jim Gallagher, and Monsignor Godfrey Mosley, that they may be safely gathered into God's kingdom in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Father, your Son Jesus Christ came into the world through the love of Mary, your servant. Responsive to your word, she brought forth our Savior. May we also hear your word and respond with joy and be pleasing in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
seals in heaven, come for us, the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for the goodness by the seed of the wine, and for the fruit of the vine, our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and kind heart, let me be accepted by you, Lord, be your sacrifice. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son, may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that the Christ was to be born among men and for men's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promises to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oscar our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen. Amen. May you all know always and everywhere the protection of her through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen.
Amen. And may you who have devoutly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Understand.